Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play Dominions 4, Thrones of Ascension, with me, Rainboy20, where we last left off. We had finally achieved an empire that reached from the northern portion of the map to the very southern portion. In the meantime, we have completely cut off Tien Chi from the rest of their empire, and Sarmatia has been reduced to a singular fortress, but Akras Fal decided to assault us. So, Sigurd has cast Augury, nothing found in Dust Fens. Akashay acknowledged, nothing found in Perigami. Pale Riders have been cast. Let's see this battle in the Griffin Spires, which is most likely them attacking us with that humongous force again. No, it's something completely different. It's just a line of long deads. Supported by Kafarin the Lion Tribe Witch Doctor. And a Mystic. Versus freaking humongous province defense. Why did the militia keep breaking? Well, thankfully that doesn't matter, the heavy infantries are stronger than the militia anyway. These are just light infantry instead of the militia. I'm bloody sick of these people. And their armies have been routed, but not without significant cost. They lost every single frontline unit. Alrighty then. Unexpected event at Dust River. People have taken some extra time off from their chores. Well, we got to fix that, shouldn't we? Worldwide event has occurred. The stars are right for alterations. Worldwide alteration rituals are cheaper this month. The sneak enemy has been discovered by the local militias. Sarmatia sent out a black servant, and the black servant was murdered. Okay. So, you've got an army to pick up. First things first, Sigdriva, pick up more horsemen. And pick up these. Are these long deads? No, these are Huskarls. Oh. Let's make the big squad even larger. And then these lions, Gunnar, are these undisciplined anyway? Yep. So this literally does not matter, except in the case of Shade Beasts. So I should actually just put you in your own squad, so you don't have a morale penalty. And you're already undisciplined, so have you down there. Bane Lord. Shoving you in the middle of that army is actually very actively detrimental. We'll put you up north, because you shouldn't be dying, especially with a robe invulnerability, which I think you have. You don't have a robe invulnerability, but you have enough fear where this shouldn't be an issue. As I just realized, the person with frost immunity has the Ring of Frost. And a thistle. Why do you have a thistle mace? Why? I don't get it. Who has more nature magic here? Of the druids, who has the most nature magic base? I know one of you guys should have extra... Like, okay. Melagog. This will go to Bifrons. Instead, Kaur. I'm so glad I noticed this. No wonder you're probably near useless. Melagog, you will get the Thistle Mace. Kaur should not be casting nature spells. And with that setup of the army, I think we're waiting one more turn so the Bane can catch up. Or maybe I could just combine these two forces together immediately. I think that'll be what happens. Actually, I could just have them all move. Why haven't I done this sooner? Alright. So we can't take that fortress immediately. Plague-Tooth and company are just running around recapturing locations, pushing them out in general. And we'll probably take this place because it's technically free from military units. I kind of forgot what I was having these guys do. I was just claiming regions. Which admittedly we're getting some very, very good area magic gem generation. And we're slowly pushing out all forces. Who's next? Solius! I think I should have you craft more items. You're going to get the Dragon Scepter so you can do some more summoning ritual stuff. Because you have the Dragon Master 1, so let's start doing some Drake summoning. Specifically, summon Fire Drake. And so you're casting Augury just so we can get our Fire Gems increased rapidly. We're not getting enough Astral Pearls to keep the Akashic Knowledge going on, but at least we can have these areas searched properly. Sphina, where are you casting it this time around? Fanglia. Where's Fanglia? I've completely forgotten. Yeah, I'll find it later. Oh, it's right here. Well, I guess there must be something there, because we've searched it with all this magic and found nothing. So maybe something will show up in that region. And everyone's moving, what research is going on, everything in construction, because you're going for those fat, unique magic artifacts. And we have tons of money. Let us spend it like we should, like the gods should. No Hellcarls, we will just fill it out with some Heardmen and Huscarls. So I need to remember that a good balance is probably better for us in the long run. We'll, of course, get some more Hellheardings and some Heardmen, because we always need more frontline troops. Down here, we'll definitely receive some troops. Although I keep forgetting I should probably build some more temples in the meantime, because we have a distinct lack of temples. And we're definitely taking back Wesh, because that belongs to me by divine right. We have a temple here. Do we have any commanders elsewhere? Do we have any commanders that are worth recruiting? We don't have a temple, so we can't recruit the people that we need to build temples. Never mind, I don't know why I was thinking that was a good idea. Oh yeah, there's a conjuration bonus. And there's a laboratory. But we need a temple. Do we have a useless person here? Cooled, technically. I can just give this to... Who would I want to give it to while I'm scratching my ear? Topicog, Hooled, what army do you have with you? Because we could just ditch that. Oh, you're carrying the undead. You can't command the undead. Okay, we have a Bane. Like, we have a person to command the undead with good reason. And then you have the magic constructs, but we have actual nature mages now. So I don't think that's a massive issue. So we're going to keep these away. Actually, Draugr, just go. And the Hound will stick with the Loyal Master. Wait, don't we have a combination of Hounds now? Don't we have more? We will... No, you stay. We'll put you here, because there's no reason to have these guys separate. The single yellow long dead, which doesn't really matter. Hooled has been completely dismantled. We're going to have Hooled run... I finally figured out how to fix that issue, as you could tell. Hooled, instead, you're going to retreat, and you're going to build some temples for me up there. Anyway, I think that's everything we could do for this turn. So I will end the turn now, and we shall see what occurs. I'll save the money. Augury has been cast, nothing kind of Paragami. Pale Riders has been cast. Fire Drake! Akashay acknowledged one new magic site in Fanglia. Karnag. Attacking... Oh, that's us. Huge army versus a fairly large province defense. However, the Yoke Wolves prove once again that they do not care, and their armies are completely annihilated. Oh, this is an actual army. Well, they lost everything but their commanders. Bolfag, an unexpected event, Harshwinter killed many poor folk. Not my problem. Haunted Woods, province income, thank you, worldwide event occurred. Alteration rituals are once again cheaper. Troops in Keisha are starving due to lack of supplies. What did we get? Keisha, fire prison. I can't believe I did not notice this earlier. So there's an enchantment bonus of 20%. At least I assume that's how that works. And 4 fire gems per turn. What did Fanglia found? Cloud pillars, astral, and air. We searched this place with astral beforehand. Anyway, you have another casting of Akashic Knowledge, and you'll get an extra one next turn for free. Hooled will continue her march, and when she makes it into Dust Fens, we will create a temple to continue spreading my domain. And at least make it so I can recruit some commanders as needed. Now, where are you casting this time around? On the Dust River. Eh? We haven't really searched it, I mean. There's a very high probability that we're going to find something. And you guys found in Karnak the Canyon of the Wind, which produces a ton of air gems. Which we have a lot of them just by sheer dint of not using them. And the nature gems, we're just not making use of those either. But first things first, we're going to pump up the province defense up to the traditional value of 50. Because I have no sense of scale. And we might be able to just take that over. Okay, Blue Moss Forest will definitely become mine. Later, when we reclaim this place. Because we definitely outnumber all of them. You know what? Take everyone. Oh, hey, Sheck. Nice to meet you. Sheck, we kind of need to move you around. You'll go up here with the main force. Pale Riders will be under your control. Although you are commanding an extra squad, but that doesn't matter because the Valkyries actually belong in the Hangadron squad, which will get your morale back up, and these are Heardmen, which will go join the Glorious Horde. Pale Riders will be directly behind Sheck. Their battle order is going to be attack closest enemy. Anything else? Out of place? Not really. We got reinforced. Sigdriva has a humongous army again. Solius, you have cast fire drakes. How many have you summoned? Just two? Ah, these are just the regular fire drakes, the ones that we've summoned and fought with before. What other magic do you know with fire? I mean, transmute fire. Excuse me, I need to cough again. Alright. Raging hearts. Fury will start to grow in the hearts of all peoples in an entire province. Those affected will soon start to kill and plunder their fellow citizens. A mage can target any province of his choice, and those affected will not know who has cast the spell on them. Vafa Flames, the spell recreates the legendary enchantment of Asgard. The fortress... Oh, okay, that's the you-can't-attack-me ritual. Eternal Pyre. He is strong enough to create 20 magical gems imbued with firepower each month. I've seen this multiple times, I just don't have a way to, you know, use it. What are summer lions? We'll do some summer lions, and how much command... Okay, you can command a fair amount of magical beings. And you're just casting augury just to locate any other fire magic sites. What do I want to do with you, gentlemen? My answer's not really much. I mean, we could try. Wow, they have a lot of fortresses right next to each other. Like, they're just spamming fortresses, and there's almost no reason for it. Oh well. I always want to run. Okay. Here's what we'll do. Do we outnumber them significantly? The answer is no, and that's why I have a problem. I guess we'll have you patrol the province. You will preach. You will also preach. You will construct a building. Can we build a fortress right here? Because this isn't a mountain, and this gives excellent resources. That's also far enough away from other fortresses, because I'm probably going to demolish this fortress. So I guess we can actually construct a fortress. How much gold do we have? Enough. We'll build an actual fortress just for the extra defense and administration. And can I have you assist in construction? No. Then I guess you will also preach, because you are a priest as well. And with nothing more to do and basically spending all my gold, I'm just going to run back here quickly, just buy 3 Valkyries, and we shall end the turn once again. Okay, a lot has happened. Nothing found in Black Alps, Akashic Knowledge, 4 found in the Dust River, Jesus. Battle in Karnag, which is probably them assaulting us. Unfortunately, the attempt is so pathetically weak that I'm probably going to ignore them. Okay, I know Legion of Steel went off. I just don't know where the spell effects are. Alright, who was killed in Karnag? Nothing of ours, almost everything of theirs. We just didn't get the mage engineer. And the battle in Wesh, which is us finally reclaiming that place from the heresies. So we have the undead, the regular humans, the magical constructs, and the main army. That is a lot of griffins. That's a lot of griffins compared to our Leogriffs. Well, there's all the griffins gone, and their forces are already routed. Well, thankfully, I think we're gonna get rid of their priestess, because our Valkyries are right here. So what do we lose? 9 long-dead horsemen, we got a griffin. How do we do that? We lost 2 Leogriffs and a Heardman. But those guys are expendable. We got a Priestess, a Myrmidon champion. We didn't get the Shaman or the Mound King. Well, expected event in Dust River. The Lake of Living Water has been found. Sentient forces dwell below the surface. Perhaps one skill in the Path of Water could bind them to service. At an Ossuary event, blocked important trade routes. Worldwide event, alteration rituals are still cheaper this month. Sneaking enemies discovered by local militia. It was a Septic and Wolves. Wait a minute. I'm going to view this battle, because that seems a little suspect. Oh, what am I talking about? We easily got them, they just retreated. I'm so sick of their septics. Drunk troops in Karnak had killed all the filthy brigands, the land is now safe and orderly, lack of supplies in Wesh, diseases are affecting the troops because we just have too much of an army. And I guess we don't really care. I'm probably going to go and... Well, of course, after buying all the province defense to ensure that they can't just take the place back. Out from behind us, we're going to go and take Akrasval. Because screw these people in particular. You've attacked us far too many times. I refuse to deal with you people. Go die in a fire. Alyssa Deathwind has run out of spells to cast. So this is a quest-type deal. Mirage, which gives us Air Gem. Enchanted Windmill, 50 supply points and Air Gem. Lake of Living Water, which grants us a Water Gem. And the Underworld. 3 Earth, Troglodyte, and Gnome. The Gnome is an old creature of Earth and Nature. Gnomes appear as small, gnarled old men with bright red caps. They usually live in forests or vales far from civilization, where they tend the flora and fauna of the region. Gnomes use illusions to hide themselves and are therefore more difficult to find. These gentlemen fit perfectly. And troglodytes with a max of 5 per month. The troglodytes are huge, stupid subterranean beings of great strength. Troglodytes sometimes side with the pale ones of Argatha. Huh. I will definitely probably buy groups of troglodytes. Well, I'll buy one. For now. Cool, you're not a water mage. Not yet. You will build me a laboratory. Oh, that's just... You're a priest. Do you have to be of a... Like, construct build... Oh, there we go. Not gonna build a gatehouse, but we'll definitely build a temple here just to start spreading my domain a bit more strongly into this place. I mean... We already know everything that goes on in this place, effectively. Their income, population, resources, they already believe in us here. But what I'm more concerned with is the League of Living Water, because I was not aware that such quests existed, as of right now. Also, we have enough Astral Pearls. And you're also going to ditch all your Astral Pearls, because you don't need them. So, what I would actually like Alyssa to do is cast again... Another Akashic Knowledge. We'll cast it in Wesh, why not? We could always know, like, everything about this place, because we haven't discovered any of their magic sites yet. After you're done building the temple, I've got a bigger plan for you involved. Solius. You summon an army of summer lions. The strength of summer units were powerful during summer and gets increased hit points during this season. Animal, wasteland, mindless, ethereal, radiates heat, and is a magic being. Well, I might as well summon more. It's not like they seem that bad, really. As fire snakes. No, we can do another fire spirit, hilariously enough. I mean, there's the problem, though, that we just don't have enough income. Oh. Why do all those take, like, 30 fire gems? Well. Okay, I guess it kind of makes sense. So these lions better be worth it. Okay, 33 hit points, and they grow a lot stronger in summer and are mindless. Okay, admittedly, that's fairly decent. Okay, with nothing else to do, we shall end the turn here, and next turn shall be the last turn of the match. Ooh. That's annoying. We are one turn away from getting access to the unique magic artifacts, which will, of course, lead to another episode of me speaking about what those artifacts are. Nothing found in Dust Hills. Cast Akashay Knowledge, one new magic site found in Wesh. A battle in Akrasfal, which is us taking down the province defenders. Oh no, it's us actually fighting them. Hello. We don't like you. Because this is our territory, and you will go die in a fire. And we will drag you down to hell with us. And of course the army of Valkyries teleports in and just murders them. Rust Mist. What is that spell? I'll have to go look that up. Naturally, we have to have the Haggadrot go out and go murder people. Oh, please kill the Mystic. Well, their armies are routed. Unexpected event in Kahnberg, a heat wave struck the land, many have died from drought and wildfires. And we found a handful of air gems that have been found in the shards of a broken mirror, and we started to destroy the gate of the fort of Akrasfal. Our fortress should be ready soon, but we'll continue sitting here defending. Now, the temple is finished here, so I want to recruit units. I could actually recruit more Woodhenge Druids, which I didn't realize. And speaking of which, there's Tritons, which allows me to convert to create the Mermans and the Merman Captains. Naturally, I would need to get some better recruitment here, and I would like some newborn Hydras, because those seem actually fairly decent. Now, Huld, before I do anything else, I want to empower you. You're going to be empowered with water. For the power of water is strong, and we're going to go visit the Dust River. And we're going to use the Lake of... We're going to have you visit the Lake of Living Water. Now, what was found at Wesh? That's Oakland. Wesh, there it is. The Prison of Hearts. Increase unrest by 5, but brings 40 gold per turn. Okay. Interesting. They're sieging, so they're not going to be doing anything. Elusive Deathwind cannot physically cast anything else. So in the meantime, while Astral Gems are building up, we will have you forge a magic item, because we still have the hammer, right? No, we removed it. Who has the hammer now? Who has the hammer but is not actually using it? Don't tell me I was dumb and sent out the commander without realizing it. I did. I was wondering where I got all this extra nature mages from. Turns out I just took all my nature mages from here. Well, you will actually stop preaching because you're no longer helpful. I want you to build a lab because we're going to be moving around some we're going to be shuffling around some magic items as they are clearly not needed. We'll just hardcraft some magic items. In this case, you're going to hardcraft some Skull Mentors, because we definitely have enough Death Gems to support it. It's Sigurd, you have the other... Oh, you have the other Dwarven Hammer. Put it in the laboratory. And you were casting Augury. Unless you can no longer cast it, because there's nowhere... Okay, you can still cast it. And, Solius. Let's see, what are the... Okay, you just summoned more Summon Lion... Or Summer Lions. We will continue doing Summer Lions. Even though we don't have enough fire gems to pull this off properly. And you will definitely grab the Dwarven Hammer while you're forging these Skull Mentors. Anyway, areas we've controlled amount to effectively nothing. I don't know. That army just retreat. We're not fully aware that this is probably a trap. I would go for it. Anyway, aside from this, I guess we can actually purchase some main frontline troops again. Well, first things first, we're gonna get a couple more mages. And some Valkyries with a few Huskarls. And over here, we will recruit another Woodhenge Druid. And some more Hirdmen. And maybe a Huskarl? No, just some Surf Warriors. Not very good, but well. And after your empowerment, you will go deal with the Troglodytes, but not before ending the turn. Anyway, this is going to be the final turn of this episode. Well, actually, no, the previous turn was the final turn of the episode, as I stated previously. And as such, I hope you've enjoyed watching. This has been BrainBoy20 with Let's Play Dominions 4 Thrones of Ascension. If you liked the video, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope to see you all next time. Farewell, everyone.